please stand and join me in welcoming the Greenfield Community College's Practical Nursing Program's graduating class of 2023. You may be seated. Thank you, and welcome to the Greenfield Community College Practical Nursing Program Pinning Ceremony. My name is Melanie Ames-Zamoyski, and I am the Dean of Nursing. On behalf of all the faculty and students here, I would like to thank you for coming to share this special celebration with our graduates. I would like to offer a special welcome to our nursing colleagues, currently active or retired, including any past graduates of our nursing program who might be in the audience this morning. It would be our honor to have the nurses in the audience please stand and be recognized. Anyone? A special thank you to our PN staff, Rebecca Wolf, Krista Klein, and Rachel Porter for their leadership in planning this pinning ceremony and for their leadership throughout their entire class. Thank you to all the GCC staff for helping to make this a special occasion today. Also a big thank you to Melissa Davis, the program administrative assistant. Certainly couldn't pull this off without her. I would like to introduce our distinguished guest on the stage, Dr. Chet Jordan. He's the Vice President of Academic and Student Affairs. I would like to welcome you to the podium.
Thank you, Dean Zamoyski. Welcome to Greenfield Community College and congratulations to all of the graduates. Let's give them another round of applause. Thank you for being here this morning for this amazing ceremony. I want to first thank Rachel and Becca and Krista for your amazing leadership. I've been here through the pandemic, and I have watched our gifted faculty and our students show up for programs that are going to put them on the front lines of work that is, at every moment, difficult and challenging. And I was on the way here, I have quite a long drive to get here, and I was on the way here this morning and I was thinking about what I wanted to say to you all. And two things came to mind. One is that you all and you all have said yes to something that most people would never say yes to. Teaching and service are one and the same. You all will teach in your work daily, just as your teachers educate you to prepare you to go into your chosen profession. Teaching itself, being a nurse, showing up and saying yes is an act of courage. A lot of people don't show up to say yes to the hard things. You all have showed up to say yes to the hardest thing. At a time that has pushed a lot of people away, you all chose to walk into the challenge, just like this. So we want to thank you for saying yes to us, and we're so glad we got to say yes to you. So on behalf of President Shute and the faculty and administration at Greenfield Community College, I want to wish you congratulations, and I want to say thank you to friends, family, who are here today to show you their support. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Jordan. It is my pleasure to announce recipients for several awards that have been chosen by the faculty to be received for outstanding achievement in the nursing program. Please come to the stage when your name is announced. For excellence in clinical performance, Courtney LaPalme.
We didn't practice this.
You don't have to stand with me. You get to do that later.
Carrying on? Yes.
For academic excellence, Wendy Criswell. Excellent job. The students have chosen by their class to represent them as their class speaker today is Kazia Lena Frater. Please join me in welcoming her to the podium.
Greetings, fellow classmates, family, friends, and faculty members. Welcome to Greenfield's Community College Licensed Practical Nursing Class of 2023 pinning ceremony. My name is Kazia Frater, many call me Zia, and it's a blessing to be here with you all today as a 2023 pinning ceremony class speaker. It's an honor to experience this milestone that will forever have an impact on our lives. It was hard writing this speech, trying to create an authentic and heartfelt way to articulate words to such a strong group of future nurses. We have experienced great memories and some bad ones while living our own lives outside of nursing school. Without a strong support system, whether it's your family, friends, and classmates that turn into lifelong friends, how would any of us accomplish such amazing things in this world? These past 2 weeks have been difficult for me. I experienced a great loss in my life, my grandmother Mimi. My grandmother was a person who lived life gracefully and approached difficult situations with a humble response. Any person she met whether a coworker or a random person in her supermarket, she had a positive and lasting effect on them. One of my favorite characteristics of hers, among like many, like resilience and humbleness, those make a great nurse. And the one that I inherited is advocacy. She lifted people up and she always advocated for people. As we enter this new journey, we have to remember that being an advocate for our patients helps ensure their well-being and also yours. Becoming an advocate for others means standing up for what is right and pointing out what is wrong, whether or not you have a hard time with it. This will make a difference in anyone's life. As the great poet Maya Angelou said, "I learned a long time ago the wisest thing I can do is be on my own side, be an advocate for myself and others like me." As we try to make a difference in our future patients' lives, we also have to remember that we all come from different walks of life. As a woman of color, it has its challenges, but I was taught by my parents to always aim high in achieving goals, no matter what society thinks. If being a class representative taught me anything, it taught me that voicing our opinion matters. But while voicing our opinions, we have to be open-minded to the ideas of others. They too can better our future. We as future nurses will see patients and their families at their most vulnerable state. I would never forget the nurse that provided care to my grandmother in her last moments on this earth. Every single one of us should strive to be that nurse, a nurse that a patient and their family would never forget. No matter what facility we are working in, we should always try to be compassionate and inspire others. These 10 months in school taught us so much in so little time. The first day of school was overwhelming, but we got through it. The first exam was anxiety-provoking, but we got through it. The spring semester of med-surg was something else, but we survived it. As we sit here, getting ready to get pinned, I hear those three words from a professor: "Well, it depends." I want to thank you all for being here for this special moment. I want to shine light and give special thanks to our families and friends that supported us throughout this program. Listening to us complain, seeing our tons of paperwork all over the table while studying, or simply doing chores for us that we didn't have the energy to do. Thank you, Professors Krista, Becca, and Rachel, and faculty members, for providing us with all the necessary resources for us to use to the best of our ability. To think this will possibly be our last time here together, I ask you to take a stand. Yes. Turn to one another and say, "We did it." Congratulations, class of 2023.
That was amazing. Thank you for that. I would like to mention one of the support systems that you've had here through Greenfield Community College and through the Practical Nurse Program is supportive money through the foundation. We've been lucky enough in our program to have an anonymous donor who's been generous and has supported some of the resources that you've been given access to for the last 10 months and going forward. Although Jean Simmons, who is a professor emeritus, is not able to be here with us today, she's hanging out in Florida, I would like to tell you a little bit about some of the options that are available to you as you move forward into your career as a practical nurse. Because there may be a time that you might want to come back to school. And forever now, I know you might not want to think about that now, but from the time that you leave this program, you're eligible for scholarship money to return. To return to come to an associate degree program or to continue on to a bachelor's level program. That's all made possible by generous donors through our foundation. So, though it may seem like a long way off, we here at GCC want to encourage you to complete, not only have you completed this practical nurse program, and you did it. And the future of nursing depends on all of you. We need you out there in the field, and the field is wide open and ever-changing, and so should we as nurses, growing and learning, which should be done daily. One of the things I try to follow is my grandfather's advice. He always told me when I was a little girl that you needed to learn something new every day. I still try to do and find something new to learn every day. So as you move ahead in your nursing career, think back to us, and we can support you through that process. Just something to remember. So today you will receive your Greenfield Community College nursing pin depicted on the front of the program. The presentation of nursing pins to new nursing graduates is said to be symbolic of the medal that Florence Nightingale received for her contributions to healthcare. On the pin, you'll notice that there is a lamp and an inscription. The lamp is a symbol for the lamp of knowledge, and may that inspire you to sustain the energy and enthusiasm for the pursuit of knowledge that you've demonstrated during your time here at GCC and throughout your professional career. The inscription reads, "The right to think, the will to learn." As caring, thinking people, continue to demonstrate the critical thinking that you have already learned to make a difference in the world of nursing. So, as you receive this nursing pin, it's also with a charge to accept the responsibilities that are implicit to the profession of nursing. Today, I have the honor, on behalf of the nursing faculty, to charge each member of the class as you join us as professional colleagues. So students, please stand. And on behalf of the faculty, we charge you to uphold the responsibilities inherent in this chosen profession, to the consistent delivery of knowledgeable, skillful, safe, and quality nursing care, to self-reflect on your care, to demonstrate legal and ethical practices and decision making, to be culturally aware and competent, to collaborate and respect your professional and nursing colleagues, and maybe the most important, but to nurture yourself. By accepting these pins, do you accept this charge?
I do.
Thank you. You may be seated. We will now begin pinning. Come on up. Emily A. Allen. Emily would like to say thank you to her friends and family for pushing her along this journey, and a big thank you to Chris for supporting her these past 10 months. Congratulations. Marta Enix Schneff. Marta would like to say thank you to her family and friends for their ongoing love and support, and to her instructors for making this year a meaningful and memorable experience. Megan Breton. Megan would like to thank all of her teachers who have helped her succeed. She'd also like to thank her husband, her parents, her mother-in-law for supporting her every step of the way. Archer and Charlie, thank you for being her biggest motivators. Wendy Criswell. Wendy would like to thank her family and friends, especially her parents, for encouraging her, believing in her, and supporting her for the past 10 months. Congratulations. Ariana Dawkins. Ariana would like to thank Mom and Dad for always supporting her no matter how big and wild her big dreams were. Thank you also to her sister who is always pushing me to do and be her best. She wouldn't be walking this stage without you guys. Arias Incarcion. Arias says these past 10 months could have been more stressful if she had not had the support of her family and friends. This achievement is not only hers, but it belongs to you as well. Mom, Rogelio, and Victor, thank you. Oba Rakakritin. Oba would like to thank Krista, Becca, and Rachel, and thank you, Jesus. Amy M. Fielding. Amy would like to say a huge thank you to her family for all the love and support. Kazia Lena Frater. Kazia would like to thank her parents for providing her with their comfort that I call a home. I want to thank my meme, mom, and twin sister for always giving her strength and motivation when it lacked. Most importantly, I want her parents and siblings to know that they are her reason to push through life. Edwin W. Juma. Edwin would like to thank his wife, Rose, and his boys, Ethan and Jeremy, for making this happen. Courtney LaPalme. Courtney would like to say that it is an honor to be walking across the stage today, and she owes a tremendous thank you, that's in capitals, for the immense support that kept her afloat this past year, from her friends, family, and her cowboy. Thank you to her children for understanding the sacrifice this year that this took for all of us, and a very special thank you to her daughter, Isabel. She'd be lost without you, kiddo. G. Jakara M. Llanos. Jakara would like to thank her professors, classmates, and Rose Marie So for your empathy, encouragement, and assistance when she needed it most. She would also like to thank her mother, Evelisa Llanos, and brother Vershawn for their love and attempts of helping her study when she was overwhelmed. Thank you, Bubby, for turning off her lights when she fell asleep and waking her up. Divine Madeira. Divine would like to thank her dad, mom, brother Andrew, and Hezron for always calling and encouraging her throughout this journey despite the distance. She also thanks her husband and believing in her. She thanks her friends Mercy, Carol, Dorothy, Pauline, Deborah, Lucky, in a special way for helping out with babysitting. God bless you abundantly. Olivia Rose Murray. Olivia would like to say thank you to her angels in heaven and her angels on earth here with her. You guys have sat with me in the dark, and now we can celebrate in the light. Chantel A. Parker. Chantel would like to thank her sister for watching over her for these past 10 months and for being her first inspiration to become a nurse. She would also like to thank her friends, family, and son, Kian, for supporting and encouraging her on this journey. Zorarius Rolden. Zorarius says, "This journey wasn't easy, but we made it." Thank you to her family, her mom and dad who didn't give up on her, her sister who was her biggest cheerleader, her love Anthony who never stopped encouraging me, and Zelvin, her son, Xavian, yeah. Xavian, her son. She came to me when she needed you most. I am a better me today than I was yesterday. Shanice Y. Romano. Romero. Shanice says she is so lucky to have such an enormous support system behind her to motivate and encourage her, to give her a good push when she needed it, and to make her good luck pancakes before an exam. This accomplishment would not have been possible without the love of her amazing friends and family. She wants to thank everyone who helped make today possible. This one's for you, Papa. Cherie Lynn Rose. Cherie would like to thank the faculty, staff, and instructors. Her classmates, friends, and family, most importantly, her husband, Jake, and son, Kalen. Your continued support and encouragement means the world to her and is greatly appreciated. Without you all, she wouldn't be where she is today. Kimberly A. Sanchez. Kimberly would like to thank her husband, children, and mom for sticking these 10 months out with her. She appreciates the changes that they had to make along the way to help get her through the program. Also, her work family for encouraging words and support every day. Lauren Marie Thibault. Lauren would like to say thank you to her family and friends for all their support that she received while going through nursing school. A special dedication to her son, Liam, for being her motivator to better herself. Thank you to all the faculty members for believing in me and giving me a second chance. Elizabeth K. Vasquez. Elizabeth says she couldn't have done this program if it wasn't for her mom and daughter. Thanks so much, Mommy and Tiana. Rich, thanks for being there too. Ashley A. Yon. Ashley says, to her parents, step-parents, and siblings, thank you for always being a phone call away. To her husband, Anthony, you are her rock, and she wouldn't have been able to have done this without you. Please join me in giving a warm round of applause for our new Practical Nursing Certificate recipient. Just a few last words. I'd like to end this with a quote from Ralph Waldo Emerson. To laugh often and much, to win the respect of intelligent people and the affection of children, to earn the appreciation of honest critics and endure the betrayal of false friends, to appreciate beauty, to find the best in others, to leave the world a bit better, whether by a healthy child, a garden patch, or a redeemed social condition. To know even one life has breathed easier because you have lived. This is what it is to have succeeded. You have succeeded here at GCC, and we are all proud of how you got here and your journey forward. We wish you joy, health, and happiness as you move forward to the next phase of your life. Congratulations. This concludes our practical nurse pinning ceremony. On behalf of the graduates, I would like to thank you for coming and sharing this special ceremony. Let us all stand for the recessional. I ask that the members of the class to remain in your seats until the platform party has exited, and the audience to remain in your seats until the graduates have exited the room, or at least get to the back. Would the platform party please begin the recessional?